Hey folks, what's up? BQ here with the Impact Lounge. If you're a first timer, especially if you're an Impact Wrestling fan, please hit the subscribe button. On the road to 4,000 likes by the Impact Redemption pay-per-view. So I just finished watching the Impact show on Twitch, The Last Chancery. Really, really solid show. Better production and audio quality and everything. Better than the Brace for Impact show. But it's still a house show, you feel me? But really good show. So while I'm watching the show and I'm in the chat room, that's when the buzz starts and people are saying Austin Aries is on Ring of Honor. So I go to Twitter and I really didn't look into it too much. I just sent out a tweet. Hey, someone fill me in on what's going on. A lot of people did. Shouts out to Miguel. You actually tweeted at me with a clip that someone else had tweeted out of Austin Aries showing up at the Ring of Honor 16th anniversary show. So of course in the comments I want to read what you guys think about this, because what I've been seeing on Twitter is a really, really mixed reaction, a mixed bag of reactions. And we got to remember, folks, we are in a different era right now. I just, like anyone else, want to see exclusivity on Impact Television, you know. But that's something that Jeff Jarrett, when he came back, tried to really, really push, and we lost a lot of talent because of it. And we're in a new age in wrestling where they're, you know, companies are looking to work together, looking to collaborate, and that's where Impact is really gonna succeed. I want to see people be exclusive, trust me, but we're not in that place right now. And I think the approach that they're taking is working. So Austin Aries shows up on the Ring of Honor pay-per-view. It's funny, the first Ring of Honor pay-per-view I ever ordered was the 14th anniversary, and I think I ordered all the pay-per-views for about 6 or 7 months, and I got a little fatigued at the style of wrestling with all the near falls and super finishers and everything. But while I don't watch a whole lot of it anymore, now my interest has peaked a little bit. Now that Austin Aries has appeared over there, and basically what he said, he called out Kenny King and said that I'm a belt collector, you know, that whole gimmick. I used to be in Ring of Honor, but there was one title in Ring of Honor that I never achieved, and it was the television title. So at first, like many others, when I heard that he challenged for the television title, I was like, well, that kind of devalues the Impact World title. But now I see where he's going. He's like, he's showing up saying, I've never won this title before. You and I have a history together, so I'm challenging you. Now, Austin Aries is not under contract with Impact. He's under... He has an agreement for a certain amount of dates, but this was one of the things that was attractive to Austin Aries when he came back, was his flexibility and the ability to work where he wanted to work. So this doesn't necessarily mean that there's a partnership with Ring of Honor. I could see where perhaps that would happen, but it's not really a partnership, but more of the flexibility that Austin Aries has to work where he wants. So some people are like, oh, there's no way Impact knows about this. No, Impact has made it very, very clear that the wrestlers are welcome to take their gimmicks and things of that nature to other places. And this is really working. I mean, watching the Twitch show, just partnering with smaller independent companies, I mean, it's just a mutual beneficial thing, because now I have wrestlers from those independent companies that I want to follow more, that I like. And it's good for Impact because they're, you know, in a sense, piggybacking off some of these promotions, but they're working together and good, beautiful things are happening. And that's what's so great in wrestling right now, because whether it's, you know, whether you're watching indies or now you're watching, you know, the secondary shows like ROH and Impact, there's so many matches you can put together, and never before seen matches. And we get surprises like this. And, you know, Ring of Honor and Impact are two shows that they're not live. But if they can utilize their pay-per-views for surprises like this and, you know, things that get buzz, then, you know, Impact's the most talked about thing right now with Austin Aries doing that. You remember how big it was when Matt Hardy showed up over there. So this is a really good thing. Some of you are going to think it's not a good thing, and that's fine. I personally think it is, and I think more people think that. And, you know, again, folks, you could turn on Raw, SmackDown, and see the same matches over and over and over again. But with this, with these partnerships, even if Impact is working with smaller independent promotions, we're seeing different stuff on a regular basis, and that is what's so lovely. So we're gonna see what happens with Austin Aries and Kenny King. You know, bit of a dream match, you could say. And we saw, not that I'm trying to compare it to Jericho and Omega by any means, but we saw what that interpromotional work did. So let's see what happens this time around. Thanks for listening, folks. This is BQ. This is the Impact Lounge. Leave your thoughts in the comments. Talk to you soon. Peace.